Hi there, my name is Kenzie. I'm here to offer you a Hatha yoga practice today here at the Everyday Counts program space. I'm only here to make suggestions, so please have whatever practice you need to have today. You'll notice I don't have any props, but if you'd like a blanket or a pillow or some blocks, please feel free, even having a chair nearby, because we'll be doing quite a few standing poses might be helpful. And please know you can press pause anytime. You can skip ahead. Find what you need here. So let's begin by making ourselves comfortable. This might be sitting in a chair or on the ground. It might be lying down. Whatever makes you comfortable. And once you've found that comfortable place, that comfortable way of being, feel free to close your eyes, to breathe through your nose if you can. And simply allow yourself to arrive here in the present moment. Perhaps begin to tune in to any sounds you can hear within your home environment or even beyond. Feel your sense of hearing reaching out in all directions, receiving sound. Move your awareness from sound to sound with open curiosity. Now I invite you to begin to listen very closely. So listening so close that perhaps you can hear your own breath, and perhaps not. And now let's begin to feel our own breath. So you might feel the air moving in past the nostrils or past the lips, and then moving back out again. You might even begin to notice that the in-breath is cooler than the out-breath. Well, let's follow that breath a little more closely as we inhale that cool air. Let's soften the belly and let that breath land deep. As we exhale that warmer air, let's feel the belly draw in. So nice, cool, deep in breath. A nice, soft, warm out breath. And this doesn't have to be the fullest in breath or the most complete out breath. This is simply a softening of the belly to expand with the in breath. And even a softening of the shoulders as the belly draws in with the out breath. Let's invite 5 or 6 more breaths just like this, cool and deep. Warm and soft. Mm-hmm. here we are now, perhaps with eyes still closed, and only if it suits you, press a hand to the belly, a hand to the chest, or even hover those hands in front. And offer yourself some sweetness here, a kind word, a prayer, an affirmation just for you. Slowly releasing those hands. Let's open our eyes. And we'll be making our way to standing for kind of a full body warm up. Now take your time coming to standing. Take as many steps as you need to get there. Maybe use a chair or a wall. And once you get there, just notice if there's something there you might touch if you need to for balance. So we'll kind of get used to standing on our own 2 feet. We might shift the weight a little bit. Just notice if those feet feel comfortably under you, you know, not too wide, not too close. You can experiment with that. Maybe we can let those arms hang long at our sides. We might play a little bit with just finding what's called our mountain pose. Yeah, maybe as we inhale, we can get a little taller. As we exhale, let's soften the shoulders away from the ears. Sometimes I imagine the fingertips heavy and the crown of the head light. So getting tall and soft. Wonderful. A couple more. And soft belly breaths. So we're going to build our body awareness from the base all the way up. So starting with those feet, again, you could walk the feet just to feel the surface of the feet, that gentle pressure of the feet against the floor. And now we'll try, and you can look at the toes for this. We're going to try lifting the toes and spreading them on one foot and then lowering them down. Let's lift and spread the toes with the other foot. And back down. We'll just go foot to foot a few times. Lift and spread, lower down. Yeah. I'm starting to notice if the feet have anything to say about this. Yeah. We could do the same with the heels. We could lift one heel, put it down. And lift the other heel. And down. So we're kind of getting used to this feeling. Shifting the weight from side to side. If this feels okay, perhaps the next time we lift the right heel, we keep it there and we kind of circle around the ball of the foot. You'll notice there's some movement to the ankle, to the knee, maybe even all the way up to the hip. We'll change the direction of the circle. Yeah. And then maybe that same foot, you can tuck it behind you, and now you're on the tops of the toes, and we'll rock from baby toes. This can be quite a juicy stretch. And I'm holding onto the wall here just as an extra support since I am balancing on one foot. And then we'll let that go. You might take a moment to notice that this right foot's feeling pretty alive with sensation, a lot of awareness there. So now we'll focus on the left foot. So we're lifting the left heel, we're balancing here, and then we're circling around the ball. There might be creaks and cracks, that's okay. Change direction. And I'm just turning to the side so you've got that side view, but also if it helps if there's a wall, I'm gonna tuck those toes behind. I'm gonna rock from baby toe to big toe. So I'm actually kind of pressing the tops of the toes into the mat a little bit, stretching the top of the foot. Finding that sweet spot even. And soft shoulders, soft jaw, soft belly breath. And now we'll come back to center and just notice how those feet feel. Again, you could walk them a bit. Yeah. And then find that upright posture, that mountain pose, Tadasana. We're gonna move down into the knees, or I guess that's up into the knees from the feet. So notice I'm going to walk my hands down my thighs. I'm going to bend the knees a little bit. And now I'm circling the knees. And I love this one because it really starts to stretch the calves and lubricate those ankles. A little bit more, a little weight bearing here as we circle. You might notice that you're circling around the edges of the feet. And we'll circle a few more times in this direction, really letting the weight of my upper body rest into those strong thighs. And we'll change the direction of the circle. Really letting those feet shift with the moving weight. We'll circle a couple more times. Wonderful. Okay, let's come back to center and stand up nice and slow. Again, walk the feet if you need to. So I'm bringing my hands to my hips. I'm going to take the feet just a little wider, slightly wider base. I'm going to start to rock the hips from side to side. And again, we're feeling the weight shift across the feet. And then we'll turn this into more of a circle. We're going to rock to one side, circle back and behind. Rock to the other side and then circle forward. And I always exaggerate the size of these circles so you can see them. But you can go nice and slow and small here. Just ease into it. We're really getting into those outer hips, listening to the back, feeling strong here if we're shifting forward, if we're shifting back. Yeah, good old-fashioned hip circles. You can change the direction here. And notice if you've kind of locked the knees, and that has a place for sure, but maybe there can be some softness to the knees, a little bend here, just to help us stay connected all the way down to the feet. Yeah, circle a few more times in this direction, listening to what I'd call the body's thoughts here, checking in with the hips, the low back, and listening to the body here. One more big circle. Great, and we'll find our way back to center. Maybe walk those feet under us, give ourselves a little shake if we need to. Moving on up. So I'd like to bring the hands to the side ribs here, if that's okay. And if it feels too high up, that's fine. You can lower down. You've got some floating ribs here. We're going to notice if we can just draw a little circle with the rib cage. And watch me. I'm going to be really tempted to move my hips here, but the challenge is to kind of move the ribs over to one side and back and around and the other side. And I could try to exaggerate this movement, but it's a pretty teeny tiny one. I'm just trying to kind of connect to those muscles halfway up the torso. And seeing if we can find a little bit of circular movement here. Yeah, that's easier said than done. I find this one challenging, but it helps me connect midway up the spine, up the torso. So I've changed directions. I'm going to circle a few more. All right, ooh, let that one go. Great. So do a little bit for the shoulders here. Yeah. Let's turn the palms out. We're just gonna notice how it feels to float the arms up. And they might stop here. They might go a little higher. And we'll float the arms back down again. More times. I'm really imagining my arms are light as feathers. I'm trying to find this easy rhythm. I know arms are heavy. I'm just noticing how it feels. And I notice the breath wants to connect here. And I notice an inhale helping rise the arms. Maybe an exhale lowers them. Yeah, I'm going to do a couple more, just letting that grow. Great, and we'll let those arms be heavy at our sides, and we'll walk. And we're going to try some lifting of the shoulders, and back down again. We'll try that. A This time we'll bring it into a slightly bigger circle. We're going to lift the shoulders up, roll them back and down, forward and up together. Yeah, and this can actually be quite sensational as we start to find these big rotations. The next time those shoulders are near the ears, let's change direction, forward and together, down, back and together. More. Yeah. All right, now the shoulders probably have a lot to say. The last little thing we'll do will involve a little bit of spinal twisting. And we're going to take the feet a little wide, and we're going to get the arms really soft and heavy. We're going to start to gently twist. So this can be the tiniest bit of movement. You'll notice my opposite heel is going to lift and that knee is going to bend. So I'm really letting the pelvis twist as well as the shoulders, the head, the neck. And we're going nice and slow here. I know we're shifting the weight from foot to foot. And the arms are really floppy, so they're going to kind of flop around the body. And you could go a little faster or a little slower. Just noticing we're maintaining this upright posture, but at the same time, we're kind of being soft and relaxed. Yeah. So do a few more. And then we'll slow it down. Gentle awakening for that beautiful spine. Yeah. And then we'll get nice and still. We'll come back to our mountain pose and just notice how it feels to be in your body now. Our last little upright part of the practice. Maybe we get a little taller on the inhale. A little softer on the exhale. One more. So here we are now. We are going to make our way onto hands and knees into what I call tabletop position. And again, take your time getting there. If you know you have tender knees, you might want to place a blanket under those knees. If you have tender wrists, I'm going to give you some options here, and you can kind of cycle through them until you build up strength in the hands so it's more comfortable to be on hands and knees. So yeah, blanket under the knees. So first position would be hands flat. Second position would be to come onto the tops of your fists. So make fists come onto the tops of them. And so I'm on the tops of my fists with the inner wrists facing each other, so you could play with that. Or you could be onto forearms. So at any point, you can try these movements on forearms. Yeah. So we're gonna keep going with movements of the spine. We did that little bit of twisting from standing. And now we're gonna move through cat-cow. So this might be familiar for you. Let's tuck the tailbone under and begin to slowly round the spine. You can push the ground away. And now we'll turn the tailbone up. Begin to slowly arch the spine, shrugging the shoulder blades together, gazing forward. Perhaps close your eyes here as you continue to tuck that tailbone and slowly round the spine from base to crown. And the same as you change the direction here, turn the tailbone up, slowly articulate to extend or arch the spine. We'll do this a few more times. And then making any adjustments you need to. And noticing the body's thoughts. You might notice the front of the body stretching as you arch. You might notice the belly and the front body sort of engaging as you round. So we'll look for that a few more times. back to our neutral spine. Shake out the hands here. Yeah. Come on to fists if you need to, or forearms. We're going to start to rock the hips from side to side. A bit like when we were standing and shifting the hips from side to side. And just like before, we're going to turn this into a circle. Let's rock to one side, circle back and around. Rock to the other side, circle forward and around. And each time we press back and around, we're taking that weight off the hands. But then each time we shift the hips forward, let's push the ground away. And so we are circling the hips, but we're also circling around the shoulders, the wrists, and the knees. Yeah. So we're circling a few more times in this direction. As usual, I exaggerate the size of this circle, but it can be a lot smaller and we'll still benefit. Now the next time your hips are moving towards your heels, let's change the direction of the circle. Again, listening to your body's thoughts. What do you feel as you circle around? Pushing the ground away. Let's circle two more times. And as you complete the next circle, let's press into a child pose. So you might widen the knees here a bit. So you drop the hips back towards the heels. Maybe we walk the arms forward and rest the forehead between. Or maybe we cross the forearms to support the head, or even stack the fists so that we can find some ease here, some comfort and support. And let's come back to that soft belly breath. And the in-breath cool and deep. Yeah, exhale, warmer and softer and slower. Couple more. Alright, when you feel ready, let's come back to our tabletop position. And we are going to come into a low lunge, which means stepping one foot forward and keeping the other knee on the mat. So what I'm going to suggest is actually to support the back knee a little bit extra, whether that's with an extra fold in your yoga mat or a blanket or a pillow. So I've got my left knee extra supported. I'm actually going to use the wall here to step forward, but however you can get that right foot in front of you. Yeah. So again, if it helps to have a wall or a chair to press into, that's great. If you want to balance upright here, you can always bring your hands to the front thigh. And also you can always take that right foot to the right a little bit to kind of widen your base. Yeah. So from here, I'm using a little bit of muscular engagement to kind of keep me here. So I'm going to press down through the front foot. And I'm also going to kind of squeeze the left butt, drawing the tailbone under, kind of like I'm trying to press that thigh forward. Yeah. From here, with my hands to the front thigh, I'm going to see if I've got a little wiggle room here. So I'm not stuck in this position. I can kind of shift the weight forward and back a little bit. Yeah. At the same time, I'm going to keep that little squeeze to the bum, that sense of drawing the tailbone down and forward, so that when I start to stretch, I keep that sort of neutral pelvis, that neutral upright position. Like, yes, I'm shifting forward a bit. I'm seeing if I can kind of keep the stretch happening in the front of that back thigh. I keep pressing down through the front foot, maybe even pulling it back a little bit. It's
starting the aging through the back of the front leg.
Again, this could be a tiny movement.
Our hip flexors here at the front of our thighs can be quite tight from sitting. So we just want to slowly enliven and stretch and invite blood flow into these tissues. Yeah. And that's why we're still doing this. Let's do this 3 or 4 more times. I like to notice what's happening in my front foot and ankle, because this is where I might have a mobility issue. So I'm noticing, can I let the knee track over the toe? Can I let the calf stretch a little bit here? Yeah. Awesome. Let's do one more. Okay, so now we're upright, back in that first position. We're gonna keep the right hand on the right thigh. Reach the left arm up if balance permits. Pressing down through the left knee, trying to get really long through that left side of the body. And now I'm side bending towards the right. And again, this could be a tiny movement. I'm going to send the left hip towards the left. So I've got this kind of reach across. And then I'm slowly kind of finding center again, coming back up. We'll try that a few more times. Stretch up. I like to squeeze that left butt a little bit. Keep it active, reach to the right, send that left hip to the left. Feel the stretch here, and then we're coming back up. Let's do that a few more times. You know, this is a pretty juicy stretch, but it just unlocks a lot of tightness that comes with sitting. So I really think it's helpful because most of us do sit. It's just part of our life. Let's do 2 more. Pressing into that front foot. Wonderful. 1 more. And then we'll meet back upright. So float the arm down. Let's bring the front leg to meet the back. And now we'll press into another child pose. You can take those knees extra wide if you want. Walk those arms extra long. And let the forehead rest. And sending some love to that left hip crease, left hip flexor, to really drop into that place and let it be soft. You've got that cool, deep in-breath. Soft, warm out breath. Couple more. And then when you're ready, let's do it all again on the other side. Your body might be feeling a little different from side to side right now. So I'm just turning around so you can see me from this side as well. Again, you can lean into something as you step the right foot forward, the left foot forward. There we go. We're going to make that extra fold. So, left foot forward. So first I'm getting balanced here. I might take that left foot to the left a smidgen. I might squeeze the right butt, draw the tailbone under. I might bring both hands to the front leg for extra support. We're going to find some wiggle room here. We're going to shift forward and back. We might press down through the front foot. We might make any adjustments here to find it. It might feel really different on this side. And as we hold tension through these hips, a little different from side to side. So we're finding our way here. Press down, let's squeeze to the butt. Honest stretch. Again, if you need this a wall or a chair the whole time, that's okay. Maybe 5 or 6 more here, slow and steady. And soft shoulders, soft jaw. But still aware of our body's thoughts, all of the sensations, asking to be heard, to be felt. A tiny bit of movement. Okay, so we're going to meet at the top here and reach the right arm up. Pressing down through that right knee, you could squeeze the right butt nice and stable here. Left hand is firmly on the left thigh, pressing that foot into the mat. Let's side bend towards the left, sending the right hip to the right a little bit. We're going to feel the stretch. And then we're going to return to that comfortable place at center. And then return to the stretch. Stretch long, reach to the left, send your right hip to the right. Feel it. Stretch it, and then slowly return. We'll do three or four more here. So we're letting that stretch be kind of intense. We're kind of tasting it, feeling it, being curious, but then slowly backing away, coming back to comfort. Easing into it, feeling it. And then back to comfort, back to that release. Let's do one more. Stretch up, reach over. And slowly back. Let's float that arm down. Let's do whatever it takes to get that front leg to meet the back. And one more child pose for good measure. Drop the hips back towards the heels. Walk the arms long. Rest the forehead one way or another. Soft, cool in-breath. Feeling that warmer out-breath soften and settle the whole body. Listening for the breath, feeling for the breath. Couple more. All right, let's return to our tabletop position. And then we'll make our way to seated. Yeah. So no surprises here as we come to seated. I like to start with the feet wide. The knees bent, so feet are at the edges of the mat. I'll back up so you can see my feet. I'm leaning right into my hands. And then rocking those knees from side to side. I've done a lot of nice stuff with the hips in those lunges, so it's really nice to just notice how they're feeling in this direction. Yeah. So again, if you practice with me regularly, you're going to know where we're going from here. From here, we're going to add our gentle twist. So if the knees are falling to the right, we lean into that right hand. We sweep the left arm off the mat. We reach around behind. Maybe we take another in-breath. Just reach a little further. And slowly back. Let's try the other side. If the knees are falling left, lean into the left hand. Sweep the right arm around and behind. Reach and stretch. Slowly back. Let's do that once more either side, just as a gentle transition activity before we explore a little more strength through the hips. Wonderful. Okay. So from here, we're going to lower down onto our side. Bend our knees comfortably. See if you can rest your head on your arm. If you need a pillow in there instead, please feel free. Yeah, and the other hand can be placed in front of us just to kind of keep us from tipping forward and back. I want you to notice your hips are stacked. And that there's almost a little space here at the waist. You're not pressing the waist down into the mat. You're kind of keeping that neutral place. Another way to say this is that top hip stays on top of the bottom hip. Sometimes I bring my hand here if I need to, just to make sure that the top hip remains sort of pressing away from me maintaining that space at the waist. So the both legs are comfortably bent. We're going to try straightening the top leg and reaching it long with the body. And let's try turning the toes down and the heel up just a bit. And this is optional as long as we can keep those hips stacked. We're going to try lifting and lowering the leg. I know this looks less like yoga and more like something else, but it's all yoga here. We're going nice and slow and we're feeling. Just feeling into the outer hip. And I know this is a lot because legs are heavy. We're asking all those outer hip muscles to do the lifting of a whole leg. And that's why I'm going nice and slow, knowing that I can rest at any time and that we don't have to go very high. Yeah. But often when our outer hips are tight from excess sitting, it's that sitting that doesn't really work the hips. So now we're exploring strength in the hips to invite blood flow and to nourish the hip joint. Going to lift three more times. Notice I'm still turning the heel down, sorry, the heel up and the toes down. I've still got some space at the low waist. I'm pressing that top hip away. I've lost count. Let's take a rest. So we're going to rest the leg beside the other one. Notice how that feels. And we'll try one more variation. So again, I'm going to take the leg long and turn the toes down and the heel up. I'm going to keep the hips stacked. Now I'm going to try drawing some circles. So half of that circle is behind me. If I were to look down at the foot as I reach behind, I can't see the foot anymore. Yeah, and this is challenging. It's a bigger range. So if this feels impossible, that's fine. Work on lifting and lowering without the circle. Yeah. And sometimes the outer hip goes, doesn't want to do it anymore. That's okay. Give it a rest. I'm going to circle two more times in this direction. Toe down, heel up. And then we'll change the direction. Again, you could take a rest in between. You could keep going. And I really feel as I press the leg behind and up, I feel those muscles. Sometimes I bring my hand there just kind of as moral support. Oh, you're working hard here. I'll do three or four more. And the feeling of strength and blood flow in these outer hip muscles can have kind of an icky kind of feeling. So let's make space for that. Let's feel all the feels here in the outer hips. We're going to try two more circles. Okay, let's rest the leg. So we're going to stretch out this hip. So let's remember which leg we were lifting. In this case, mine is my right hip, so I'm going to refer to the right leg. So we're going to roll onto our back. And these are bent, feet are hip distance apart. Same leg I was lifting. In this case, my right leg, I'm going to lift the foot and then place that ankle over the left thigh. Going to flex the foot a little bit, which means turning the toes up, and then press the knee away from me. And you will likely feel quite a strong stretching sensation in that right hip or in the hip of the leg you were lifting, the one you've placed on the left leg. Yeah. So this might be enough stretch for you right here. And again, we're flexing the foot to keep that knee fairly comfortable. But you could even rock a bit from side to side if you find that soothing. Or if you're not feeling much stretch, it really just depends on your body. You could lift the opposite foot and even hold on to the shin or the thigh. You can tell I can't even reach those. Sometimes I'll even grab onto that lifted foot in front and pull it towards me. So let's offer a few more breaths here, whatever you need. And I will add one more variation. So I've lifted my right foot because that's the one I've been lifting. And now I'm going to rock onto my outer left thigh so that the right foot can press down into the mat. And then maybe I reach that right arm away from me. Maybe I look in that direction. Pressing down through the right foot or the lifting leg foot as I press the knee away. And this stretch doesn't speak to everyone, but some people it does. So if you're happy here, invite a few breaths, explore that unique sensation, or come back to that first position for those last three breaths. Right, so we're going to meet back at center. Let's uncross that leg nice and slow. Let's take the feet wide to the edges of the mat and rock those knees like windshield wipers. And this is just going to soothe the low back, the hips, before we move into this leg lifting on the other side. All right, so when you're ready, you can either roll to the other side away from me, so you know you're using the other leg, or you can make your way to the other end of your mat. And so I'm resting my head on my arm or using a pillow, and comfortably bending the knees, and then just checking in on that top hip. I'm sort of pressing it away to make space at the low waist. You keep the other hand in front for balance here, or again, you could keep it on the hip. So legs are comfortably bent, but we are going to reach the top leg long with the body. Turn the toe down, heel up, and play with lifting and lowering. So you can make any adjustments here. Really let the head be soft. Though some people naturally like to keep it up with their hand under their head, and if that's comfortable for your neck, great. I'm noticing my hips remain stacked. My toes are pointed down, my heel up. And I'm moving nice and slow. It's not really about counting repetitions. It's just finding strength here, finding a rhythm. And even noticing if you're still breathing. Let's do maybe five more. Slower than you want to. Really curious where the challenge is. And what the sensations are as we start to invite blood flow and awareness into these outer hip and glute muscles. Yeah. We just so rarely challenge these muscle groups in our everyday regular activities. So it's so curious to ask the body to do something novel. Yeah, so we'll do a couple more of these novel leg lifts. And novelty makes the nervous system pay attention, does increase body awareness. Okay, let's rest that leg. Let's find that soft, cool in-breath. Warmer, slower out-breath. Soften what you can. Couple more. And let's now add those circular movements. So I'm going to keep those hips stacked, maybe hand to the front for balance. I'm going to reach the leg long with the body, toes down, heel up. I'm going to draw a circle. Again, this can be a tinier circle. I always exaggerate a bit. And as I reach behind me, there's the stretch to the thigh. There's the strong engagement. I reach in front. So half that circle, I can't see my toes if I were to look down for them because I'm reaching behind. And again, there's novelty to this movement. And so if the muscles are really resisting, if they're tightening or cramping, this is kind of a hint that this movement might be just right for you. It might be something the body actually needs a little more of. Let's change the direction of the circle. Again, toes down, heel up. And you can do this exercise standing on one leg, circling that other leg out to the side. It's going to be less intense, might be more accessible. If you think about sort of the gravitational pull on that leg when you're standing as opposed to lying on your side. Yeah. Let's do three more, slow and steady, slower than you want to. Still stack the hips. I'm still aware of sensation. Not just pushing through, but really being here for this final circle. Beautiful. And we'll put the leg down. So remember which leg you were lifting. In this case, it was my left leg. So I'm going to roll onto my back. Bend the knees, feet are about hip distance apart. I'm lifting the left leg, or whichever leg I was lifting before. I'm lifting it, pressing the ankle across the opposite thigh, pressing the knee away. This could be quite a juicy stretch, just like this. I flex the foot a bit to keep the knee happy as I rock from side to side. Perhaps I want to lift the opposite foot, holding on to the thigh or the shin, or even holding on to the foot. Yeah. Again, a little rock here. One more variation, if you so choose, and bring that right foot back to the mat. As I rock onto the outer right thigh, I'm pressing the left foot into the mat, pressing the knee away, and maybe looking to the left, kind of softening those shoulder blades onto the mat. And if this doesn't speak to you, just come back to that first position. A few more breaths. And when you feel ready, once more, let's uncross those legs. Let's take the feet to the edges of the mat. Rock the knees from side to side. So it is just about time for final relaxation. So perhaps you want to keep those knees rocking a little bit more. Perhaps you want to hug the knees into the belly, a gentle rock here from side to side. Perhaps there's another pose or stretch or movement you wanted to do today, and please feel free. When you're ready to move into that final relaxation pose, please make yourself as comfortable as possible. Perhaps a blanket, perhaps a pillow. Yeah. You're always welcome to move into a chair or onto a couch or even into bed as we settle into this final relaxation pose. Once you are comfortable, perhaps close your eyes. And begin to breathe through your nose if you can. Make any adjustments to your body to increase your comfort. Your comfort matters most of all to this practice. Let's once more drop into the sense of hearing and let your sense of hearing reach out in all directions, moving from sound to sound with open curiosity. now begin to bring that sense of hearing so close that you listen for your own breath. Now let's begin to feel our own breath. Notice how the in-breath feels cool against your nostrils or against your lips. And the out-breath feels warmer. Cool breath in. Warmer breath out. Now let's follow that cool breath in and feel the belly softly rise. Warmer breath out and the belly falls. The chest is quiet. Cool in breath, belly rising. Warmer out breath, belly falls. Cool in breath, warmer out breath, belly rises, belly falls, stay with the journey of the breath. You can focus on the temperature. You can focus on the rise and fall of your abdomen. Or the journey of the breath in between. But stay with it. If your mind begins to wander, that's okay. That's what minds do. But perhaps come back to the journey of your breath as you allow your body a few more moments of stillness and rest. That cool breath in, the belly rises. Warmer breath out, the belly falls. Focus on the belly, or focus on the temperature of the breath. And simply stay here with what is. If you feel a deep need to remain still for a little while longer, please do so. If you're ready to invite some movement, maybe it's your fingers or toes, or maybe a slow turn of your head, a stretch, a yawn. You may feel like bending your knees and rolling over to your right side into a fetal position, maybe keeping your eyes closed a little while longer. Perhaps finding that top hand, you could press it into the floor in front of you to help guide you upright. Perhaps joining me in a comfortable, upright, seated position. If it suits you, perhaps bring a hand to the belly and a hand to the chest once more. And once more, offer yourself some sweetness, that kind word, that prayer, that affirmation that we offered at the beginning of our practice. Let's offer it to ourselves again now. Releasing your hands, slowly opening your eyes. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions or concerns, always feel free to reach out to us at the Everyday Counts program. I hope to see you again soon.